In the year 2026 AD, the Earth-Rage tectonic disturbance occurred around the world, splitting the Earth into four terrestrial masses. Domination, war, disaster, and famine broke out in the four lands, and mankind fell into disarray. In the center of the world, a single tower rose steeply into the sky. It was a great structure looking down upon the Earth from the heavens above. People believed that it held the key to the future. It became known as the Tower of Barbs, a place at which one could come closest to God.
Another new arrival. Looks like things are about to get busy around here.
Waiting for you. This is your first time riding line 15, huh?
I know.
It's not a very well-known line, I admit. Anyway, this is the last stop.
Hello everyone, and welcome to Doom Epitaph's Let It Die walkthrough Let's Play. First thing I have to do is set up the audio settings. Let's have a look quickly. There we go. Turn off the speaker. And that should do it. Now, I've already played through Let It Die some time ago, and I figured I'd play through again. With all the changes that have happened over the course of the game's life, it'll be likely a completely different experience going through this time. Now, the main goal for me in this walkthrough will be to reach floor 40 and see how quickly I can get there. And maybe I'll do some side challenges too, the Forcemen and other events. Now, I won't be trying to get every single armor and weapon blueprint in this walkthrough, but I will stick to some of the essential weapons and armor that will make it easier to get through the game. I'll try and read all of the tutorials and collectibles, if I can remember to do so. I'll try not to talk about any content that I haven't explored yet to make the walkthrough as spoiler-free as possible. Also, I'll be playing through the game, spending no money on it whatsoever. Now, I'll do my best to explain everything as I go along and give some tips here and there. Feel free to put your thoughts and questions in the comment section below. Let's get started. Okay, so let's have a look at this Underworld Rolodex. This is the main menu of the game, where all the information on the collectible items on your fighter and tutorials can be found. There's no really much information here available yet, but we'll be filling these things up as we go along. There's mushrooms, beasts, skill decals, quests, player data. Now, the first thing people will notice as you go along is your character has a stamina bar in the form of a beating heart, and it will beat faster and faster the more stamina you use up. Now, there's a roll, there's attacking with the R and L triggers, and there's a sprint with L3 on the PS4 controller. And when your heartbeat goes too fast, going towards the purple color, you end up without stamina and you have to recover for a few seconds. So we start off in the train station. We're not able to get through to our waiting room. Instead, we'll go up to through this escalator to Ikegara, first floor.
It's me. This device here, as all the cool kids call it, is a smartphone. I'll be keeping in touch.
Okay, we can't go back. Let's go and see what this thing is. These are your controls. The left triggers are the attack buttons. Circle for dodging, square for jumping, X button to interact, camera controls, the right analog, movement, left analog. The map is the down arrow.
Three levels of punches.
Okay, so that's the first enemy in the game taken care of. And you loot weapons by pressing the arrow keys. The right arrow will swap through your right hand weapons. The left arrow will swap through your left hand weapons. And while you're standing over an equipable item, you press the right arrows until the item slot you want to equip that item in, and then press X to confirm. About equipment. Many pieces of equipment are featured in the game. Let's take a look at a few basic rules. The equipment types. Equipment includes weapons which may be equipped on the right, left, or both hands, and three types of armor: head, upper body, and lower body. Durability. Every piece of equipment has durability, which decreases each time it is used. When the durability reaches zero, the equipment will break, so be careful. One- and two-handed weapons. There are single-handed weapons which you can equip in each hand, and double-handed weapons which you can only equip one of. It's your choice which weapon you become proficient with. Death bags. You can store and carry the various items you find in the tower in your death bag. About weapon quick change. Both the left and right arm have three weapon slots. Use the directional buttons to quickly switch between weapons equipped in these slots.
Jump and shimmy up there somehow.
Rage moves. In this game, you can unleash rage moves, techniques which are stronger than regular attacks. If you use these effectively, you will have an advantage in battle. The rage gauge. Each time you deal damage to an enemy, your rage gauge will build. This will increase in level until it reaches the maximum. Activating rage moves. When the rage gauge is full, hold triangle as you attack to unleash a powerful rage move with your equipped weapon. The number of gauges used up by the rage moves depends on the weapon you're holding. Okay.
Hey, up ahead, Taylor, who's this? Time for some killing.
Okay, they haven't noticed me yet. Now, with rage moves, if you hold the triangle button, you activate rage mode, and if you attack with your R2 or L2, depending on which hand you're holding the weapon in, you'll unleash rage moves. Okay, so if I want to attack with my left hand, I have to press triangle and L2. With the equipped weapon in the right hand, I have to press triangle and R2. And you can tell if you can, if you're able to use a rage move by the glowing arms on your fighter. So I got 3 rage gauges filled. The number next to my character's health at the top. And it costs 1 rage to use the rage move of the unarmed. Now it costs 2 rage to use the rage move of the hammer. I think I'll use it on this guy. Okay, I just filled another rage meter. I got 1 rage, so I can use the unarmed rage move again.
Nice, that was pretty sweet. Senpai, when you pick up items, you can choose to put them in this death bag instead of carrying them. Equipment, mushrooms, anything you can't carry can go in there.
Okay, death bag. So now the death bag has become available to access for me. This is your basic storage room. These are all the items you've got on you. Even equipped items will end up in here. So I can choose to equip the gear that I'm standing over by pressing up to equip armor. Or I could put it in my death bag if I wanna, if I don't wanna equip it. Now to equip this, I'll press up and X to accept. And in the death bag, you can press X to interact with items. So you can move the weapon hand you're carrying your weapons in. You can switch that out. You can choose to drop an item on the floor. That'll appear in the game world. And you can also let's see. You can put it back in your death bag from your equipped mode. So if there's a little E, top right corner, means you've equipped this these gear. Go ahead and equip the hammer and the Dr. Joe body again. Eating mushrooms. You will encounter various types of mushroom in this game. They have many uses, but here we'll explain their role as food items. When you draw close to a mushroom, they can consume it quickly by selecting the eat icon, which will be displayed. When you put mushrooms in your death bag, they will be displayed in the flick box at the top right of the screen. Flick on the mushroom you want to eat with the touchpad and eat it by clicking the right side of the touchpad button. Mushroom effects. Not all mushrooms are beneficial to the player. Some mushrooms contain poison that can result in death, so be careful.
Eat mushrooms! That's a given.
Okay, so we have the interact option while standing over the mushroom again. Down to put it in our death bag. Or up to eat the mushroom. I'll go ahead and pick this one up. Now the top right, you can see your usable mushrooms. Gear elements. There are 6 types of equipment. Slashing, blunt, piercing, fire, lightning, and poison. Weapon types. You can hold up to 2 types of weapons at the same time. It's important to pay attention to the type of armor the enemy is wearing and manage your weapons accordingly. Armor types. Armor has a defense value that varies with the type. It's important to pay attention to the enemy's weapon and switch accordingly. Okay, I'll go ahead and equip this crossbow in the left-hand slot 3. Looks like there's a bunch of mushrooms lying around here. Oh, I'll pick this one up as well.
Wanna give me some of those mushrooms?
Okay. I think that's gonna be it for the first episode. I'll see you guys in the next one.